The spider-tailed horned viper, Pseudocerastes urarachnoides, is a remarkable example of nature's ingenuity. A predator whose method of hunting is as deceptive as it is effective. Found in the rocky, arid landscapes of Western Iran, this snake has evolved a unique adaptation that sets it apart from all other vipers. The tip of its tail closely resembles a spider. This illusion is not just for show, but serves as a highly specialized hunting tool, allowing the viper to lure unsuspecting birds into striking distance. Among the many creatures that have developed forms of mimicry for survival, few are as fascinating as this snake, which uses its appearance to create a deadly illusion. Despite being known to local communities for years, Pseudocerastes urarachnoides was only formally described as a species in 2006. Initially mistaken for a variant of the Persian horned viper, Pseudocerastes persicus, it was later recognized as a distinct species due to its unique morphological traits. Its body is well adapted to the harsh desert environment, with rough, earth-toned scales that allow it to blend seamlessly into the rocky terrain. The most striking feature, however, is the modified tip of its tail, which bears a remarkable resemblance to a spider, complete with appendage-like protrusions that mimic legs. When the snake moves its tail, the effect is so lifelike that it fools even the keenest-eyed birds into believing they have spotted an easy meal. This specialized caudal luring technique is what makes the spider-tailed horned viper such an extraordinary predator. Unlike other vipers that rely on patience to ambush rodents or lizards, this species has honed its hunting method to target birds. The snake selects an optimal ambush spot, usually a rocky crevice or a patch of desert where it can remain perfectly camouflaged. Coiling its body motionlessly, it leaves only its tail in clear view, twitching and wriggling it in a manner that perfectly mimics the erratic movements of a real spider. Small insectivorous birds, particularly warblers, shrikes, and sparrows, are naturally drawn to this movement. Seeing what appears to be a helpless spider, they swoop down in an attempt to snatch their prey, only to be met with a lightning-fast strike from the viper. Once within range, the snake wastes no time. With an explosive burst of speed, it lunges at the unsuspecting bird, sinking its venomous fangs deep into the victim's body. The hemotoxic venom quickly incapacitates the prey, breaking down its tissues and ensuring that escape is impossible. Within moments, the bird succumbs, and the viper begins the slow, methodical process of swallowing it whole. Thanks to its highly flexible jaw, the snake is able to consume prey much larger than its head, an ability common among vipers, but particularly useful for a species that preys on birds, which are often relatively large compared to the snake's body size. The evolution of this hunting strategy raises interesting questions about natural selection. Most vipers primarily target small mammals or reptiles, yet Pseudocerastes urarachnoides has adapted to specialize in bird predation. The scarcity of rodents and other ground-dwelling prey in its harsh desert habitat may have driven this species to develop its unique method. Birds, particularly migratory species, are an abundant and energy-rich food source in this region, making them an ideal target for a predator that has mastered deception. Unlike mammals, which rely on smell, birds primarily use their keen eyesight to locate prey. The spider-tailed horned viper exploits this weakness, presenting a perfect visual lure that plays directly into the instincts of its avian victims. While research on the venom of this species is still limited, it is believed to be similar in composition to that of other Pseudocerastes vipers, primarily hemotoxic in nature. It acts swiftly, destroying red blood cells and tissues, causing severe pain, internal bleeding, and paralysis. The potency of the venom ensures that the snake does not have to engage in prolonged struggles with its prey, a crucial advantage when hunting fast, flight-capable creatures like birds. Although extremely rare, bites on humans would likely result in serious symptoms, though this species is generally not considered a major threat to people due to its remote habitat and secretive nature. The spider-tailed horned viper is found exclusively in Western Iran, particularly in the rugged terrain of the Zagros Mountains. It thrives in dry, rocky environments where its camouflage is most effective. preferring crevices and desert outcrops that provide both concealment and strategic vantage points for hunting. The isolation of its habitat has contributed to its relative obscurity, with only a handful of recorded sightings since its discovery. However, this remoteness does not entirely protect it from threats. Like many rare reptiles, the illegal pet trade poses a risk to Pseudocerastes urarachnoides. Collectors are often eager to obtain exotic species with unique physical traits, and the snake's spider-like tail makes it a particularly sought-after specimen. Habitat destruction due to human activity, including mining and infrastructure development, also threatens its populations. Additionally, climate change may further impact its environment, potentially reducing the availability of prey or altering temperature conditions in ways that could disrupt its survival. As of now, the species has not been officially classified under the IUCN Red List, but conservationists stress the importance of continued monitoring and protection efforts to ensure its long-term survival. The spider-tailed horned viper is one of the most extraordinary predators in the reptile world, a living testament to the power of evolution and adaptation. Its ability to manipulate the instincts of birds, transforming its own body into a biological decoy, is a striking example of natural selection's ingenuity. This rare and enigmatic snake remains one of nature's best-kept secrets, a master of deception lying in wait in the rocky deserts of Iran, patiently weaving a trap of illusion and death.